I'm Lieutenant Commander David Lindberg. I am a staff officer to CTU 356-0103, as we call him. My personal task is mainly to draft reports that we send up to the higher command, and also to draft orders that we send out to our own task units. One of the biggest challenges is to plan so that we have the ability to do sustained operations in the area, because if we can't fulfill our tasks in 5 days, it's no use that we are very good at this today. And what we also do is that we create a basis for the task unit commander's decisions. So he makes the decisions and we create the situational awareness and give him the facts and the assessments to make decisions on.
My name is Fabian Tam, and I'm a lieutenant in the Royal Swedish Navy. And here on board HMS Visby, I work as an N4 officer, and that is a branch with logistic. The personal thing is to see to it that all the ships has all the necessary equipment to be able to do their task out on the sea.
The task for the TU staff is to plan ahead so that we know what we will do tomorrow and the day after tomorrow. And also to make a contingency plan if something new arises, and if there is a what we call a be prepared to task that we're assigned from the higher command, we need to have a contingency plan in case that task is ordered. And we also have to react to unforeseen situations as they arrive, and that could be everything from logistics issues to someone who tries to affect our operations and needs to be handled in accordance with the rules of engagement.
And our task in the CTU staff is to establish RMP in this area of responsibility. RMP stands for Recognized Maritime Picture. That means that all ships should see the same picture in the area.
What we're focusing on right now is to create what we call freedom of movement, and that means, for example, clearing wartime minefields in the sea, so that we and other people who needs to use the sea lines and the fairways can do that in a safe manner.
The current status in the task unit when it comes to logistics at this moment is rather good, I would say. Most of the fuel things and when it comes to spare parts and everything, and that is quite good.
Mainly we're cooperating with the other task units of the Naval Task Group at sea, but we also cooperate with areas such as maritime patrol aircraft. We cooperate with land forces, and we cooperate with governmental organizations and non-governmental organizations in the area. For example, the World Food Program and different port authorities and so on.
During this exercise, we have encountered quite a lot of frictions between nations, between ship types, and stuff like that. And it's very important to be able to do that as well, because we need to see what type of friction we will meet when we go together to a new mission, for a real mission. I think the exercise is giving us a heads up what to do and how to proceed in the future. We involve the entire Baltic Sea region and do exercise. We learn quite a lot of it, and we can see quite a lot of frictions as well, but that's good.